Hi everyone, welcome back to Red Carpet With. Alright, as you know, it's me, Shah, again, and every week I get to speak to the most beautiful and talented people for my show. And today we've got the extremely talented and beautiful Fazura. Hi, Faz.
Hi, Shah.
How are you?
Good, thank you very much.
Alright, I'm not going to waste much time because the reason why we have Fazura is because, first of all, she's got a new movie out.
Yes.
Alright, you've got a new movie out.
Yeah.
But my first question is, you've been a bit off the radar. We haven't seen Fazura much, okay, in movies, on TV. Where has Fazura been all this while?
I have been around. It's just that I've been not acting so much because I don't think at this stage of my life I have the energy to do 4 or 5 different dramas a year. And so, but then I have been around. I have done 3 movies last year, and I did like a 13-episode drama series called Kisah Cinta.
Okay.
But this year, I promise you will see more of me because I spent so much money last year on shopping.
Okay.
So this year, I have to work hard and get all the money back.
You mentioned 4 or 5 dramas, in 1 year, and you don't have time to do that. But it's actually more about 4 or 5 things in one go. We know apart from acting, you're also a businesswoman, and you've been endorsing products. So that's where we didn't see you on TV acting, we saw you doing all these other things. So maybe you can tell us a bit about these other things you're doing.
Well, fashion has always been my passion for so many years, and so I've decided to realize my dreams and passion in fashion. And so House of Doll basically came into mind. Okay, I love fashion, and so let's start a fashion line of mine, and as well as a clothing store. And so since I have House of Doll, which was launched 27 May 2012. I've been so busy with that, and that's probably one of the reasons why I have not been acting so much, and I love it. I've been an ambassador for, as you know, for Nutox and Lux for so many years now. I think for 4 years now, and now I'm also an ambassador for Colgate. And coming soon for Avon.
Yeah. See, so many things going on. Yeah. Where do you find the time to do all this? And you're still acting despite all that.
Yes, I am still acting. But you know, I've always been very selective before, as
yes.
you know. So I'm a little bit more selective now.
So you don't simply take.
I don't take 4 or 5 movies just to stay relevant. I think. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. That's interesting because some actors, of course, they have no choice. Well, perhaps it's a matter of comfortability.
I'm very blessed. Very blessed. Yes. Very, very blessed.
All right. Now, House of Doll is your fashion line. It's in Bangsa, of course.
Mm-hmm.
We know that.
Yeah.
And how long has it been ready since House of Doll has been launched?
I think it has been like a year.
Yeah.
So
and
now.
Response?
Very good. Very well. We have thousands of customers now, you know, and many, many, many regular customers. And so because of that, I will push House of Doll a lot more this year because of the support that I've been getting. Alhamdulillah.
Okay. All right. Now, from your side business and everything, we move on to your latest venture. Okay. Like I said, we haven't seen Faz in so many movies. It's been a while. Suddenly, last night, I was one of those very fortunate ones. As you know, media, we get to watch movies first before you guys. So I attended the gala premiere of Kami Hysteria. Now, it is Fazura's latest baby. I mean, she's one of the stars in it, all right? One of her latest movie. And it's a very, very different movie. So maybe before I talk more about it, I'll let Fazura tell us a bit about the movie.
Oh my God, I can't remember when was the last time I did a movie. I think it was Bujang Telajak. It was probably like 3 years ago.
Yeah,
and so it's
Telajak
Jauh. Yeah, Telajak Jauh already. So it's very exciting to be able to attend your own movie premiere again. And I can never get used to it because I was there last night. I'm like, oh my God, I'm in a movie. You know, it feels so strange to me now. But Kami Hysteria is such a fun movie. I get to play a very sexy Lang Sui.
Okay.
So, what's Lang Sui in English?
Lang Sui, Banshee.
Banshee.
Like a vampire, but it's a Banshee.
Banshee.
Yeah.
Okay, a very sexy Banshee. And she is not a typical Lang Sui that you've seen before, or Pontianak that you've seen before. You know, as you see, like many movies about Pontianak or about any ghost in Malaysia has always been very revengeful.
Okay.
You know, they've always been very angry and stuff like that. And what you're going to see in Kami Hysteria, Cik Lang is a very... she's a very happy... Cik Lang is a character. She's a very happy girl.
Okay.
You know, I think that she has lived a happy life. It's just that she had one dream that has not been fulfilled when she was alive. So she had the opportunity to meet 5 girls, and they're at an event. And they came and requested something from her. But she said, okay, I'll fulfill your request, but I will need something from you guys. So
all ghosts and spirits.
Yes, yes. And Chek Lang is such a happy ghost. Okay. She's such a happy ghost. She's funny and she's stylish and she's a very interesting character. And I really had fun playing Chek Lang. Yeah.
Okay, all right. Now, actually, like I told you, I watched the movie. It's amazing. It's hilarious, entertaining. Okay, I strongly suggest you watch it. It's purely for entertainment. Now, in the movie, you work with five very talented people. You just mentioned the five leading ladies. Mm-hmm. All right, one of them is
very beautiful.
Daniel. Yes, all pretty. Yeah. Diana Daniel, Nat Zainal, okay.
Mila Jirin and
Mila
Sarah
Jirin
Ali.
Mila Jirin and Sarah Ali as
yes,
well.
Yes.
Now, my question, before this, like you said, years ago, we saw you acting. Fazura was a celebrated cast, okay? She is one of the girls. Like, in Pisau Chuko, you were with Maya Karin, okay? And then Golden Ginchu, you were with Sazi and all these people. Yeah. Now, in this movie, I see it, as a member of the media, I see it like, these five girls are actually the leading lady, but somehow they have this special spot for Fazura. It's like, Fazura is placed on a special, like a throne or something. It's like, okay, they even the poster, if you notice, Fazura has a big picture of her on it. Okay, now, do you think that is something which is, how do I say it? It is a career progress for you where they put you as a star, as the main attraction, or you think it's just part of a normal marketing campaign for a movie?
Well, Chek Lang is a very interesting character and a very important character in the movie. And so, like, without Chek Lang, it will not be completed. It will not become Hysteria. It will just be about five girls. And so, I think what makes Kami Hysteria interesting is because of Chek Lang. It's because of a Lang Sui who wears kebaya and is funny.
She speaks with a Utara dialect.
So basically, I think it's just a marketing thing,
okay,
really.
Yeah. Right. Well, I'm sure it must be a compliment for you to, you know, be placed among these five leading ladies, and yet they still put Fazura, because we remember watching the credit title at the end. Fazura's name is number five or number six.
Yes.
But the attraction at the poster itself, it's like Fazura. It's a crowd puller. So I guess you must have come a long way, you know, like.
Well, I'm blessed, you know, I'm blessed. I think that everything happens because of Allah. And I've always believed that. And people say, like, in the early years of my career, I remember being told, like, you know, you have to do five projects a year. You have to keep, you know, being in the limelight. And I was never the type that liked the limelight. And so because of that, I think I was sort of, I'm blessed because I'm not so much out there. And people probably want to see more of people who are not really out there. So,
I'm blessed.
Thank you so much.
All right. We'll ask more questions. I got some more interesting questions. I mean, you just came back from the States, okay? But before we move on to that, we're going to take a very short breather. All right, Red Carpet with Fazura. We'll be right back. Stay tuned. Don't go away.
This January, daily luxury can be found with Lux Today. For 2014, stay tuned from Monday to Thursday for all the latest luxury and lifestyle news from around the world. With reports focusing on fashion and accessories, dazzling jewellery and watch collections, luxury brands and five-star hotels, not forgetting food, gastronomy and wine. Finally, Lux Today also brings you the best nature reports and travel ideas. In 2014, Lux Today will feature even more amazing reports on the most iconic luxury brands. Last but not least, don't miss our world tour, bringing you reports on the art of living from all four corners of the globe. With Lux Today, Lux TV wishes you a 2014 full of luxury and surprises.
Wood that can take the heat. Space age undies that don't stink. A miniature car you can program. From the hottest gadgets to the coolest exhibits. It's a showcase of unique products from a wide range of industries. All Japanese ideas and technologies. Yours to discover each week on Great Gear.
Hi, welcome back to Red Carpet with still talking to the very pretty and talented Fazura. Okay, we talked about so much from her movie career to what she's been doing and, you know, her latest movie. Okay, she mentioned just now in her movie she plays a banshee, okay, Chek Lang.
Yeah.
Right? this very beautiful person who, actually she's not a person.
She's a happy ghost.
Yeah, she's a happy ghost, alright? Voiced by Shafinaz, actually, when she sings.
When
right?
she sings, yes, that's when right. She sings, I couldn't possibly sing like that.
It's Shafinaz's soprano vocals, which you hear. So that's why I said you have to watch the movie. Super, super wonderful combination. Now, okay, you mentioned just now, all right, you know, you don't take too many movies in a year, too many projects, but you did say at the beginning, this year your fans will see more of Fazura,
yes, yes.
Okay? But despite all that, Fazura is always traveling. She's always out and about, and we know you just came back from the States. You share this on social media affectionately, okay? All right, so maybe you can tell us this sudden urge, suddenly you left for the States. Why was that?
Well, because I've always been traveling. As you know, I've always been traveling just the cliche places like London, Paris, and all that. So I've always wanted to visit the States, and I've decided that this year, December would be the perfect time to go. And so I did, and everybody was asking me, like, why did you go to the States for so long? Like, 3 weeks is such a long time. But, you know, it's the flight so long. It's like 22 hours. And at the same time, there's so many places in the States that I wanted to visit and stuff like that. And I did that. I didn't disappear. I just went for holiday. I came back.
Because there were a lot of speculation. They were saying, oh, maybe she's going there to meet someone.
Oh,
okay. And
right.
then you also met Yuna as well.
Yes, I did.
So
yeah.
tell us about that.
Yeah, I have friends in the States. And so, obviously, naturally, when I plan a trip, you know, I look back, so who do I know in LA? So I actually have friends in LA, and one of them is actually a DJ, and he's also a manager for Infected Mushroom. His name is Randy Seidman. And so I was there, and then he took me to all these places and stuff, and I met new friends, I met old friends, and it was fun, yes.
Okay, and because like I said, a lot of people follow you on your social media platform, so we were like, oh, wow. And then you met Yuna, must have been a big deal. Do you watch her on her show, by the way?
Yes, I did, Jimmy Kimmel.
Yeah, she
went to the Jimmy Kimmel
show.
And I was in the crowd, I was, you know, being one of her fans, like, oh, Yuna, it was fun.
All right, and that was also the time when you went to the States, your Twitter account got verified.
Oh,
right?
yes.
All right.
Yes.
So it must be a big deal. I mean, not many Malaysian stars have that privilege.
Yes.
So, you know, finally you're verified and people cannot use fake accounts and say they're Fazura. Now, speaking of fake accounts and following Fazura, okay, a lot of people in Malaysia, your fans particularly, say there are some new stars who try to be you, imitate you, okay? Some, I guess, tried very hard, but like I said, any star, there can only be one. So your comment about all these people trying to be you, new stars.
Yeah. You know, they say that imitation is a form
of flattery, right?
Yes, best form of form of flattery. And so, I've always been, when people come up to me and say, oh, this new actress is like so in love with you, and they say you're the kakak lah and whatever, it's nice. Of course, I feel like so honoured. And but then at the end of the day, I did and I have been hearing stuff, especially last night, the press came up to me and said, what do you think about this particular, you know, celebrity or that particular celebrity trying to be you? I really don't. It's not a huge thing to me. It's something
that. Do you see it as something bad? Is it something
no,
bad?
I think that it's not something
it's
bad.
A compliment.
It's a compliment. But of course, like I think, for any human being, if you're being if somebody is imitating you from head to toe and exactly trying to be you, it annoys me sometimes.
Sometimes, okay.
But it's not a big thing.
So
yeah.
You're actually
I'm okay with that.
That.
I'm okay with that. Of course.
Okay. All right. Well, we just wanted to know. We wanted to clarify. And throughout your career, like I said, we first knew Fazura when you first appeared in your first movie. That was way back.
Bicara Hati.
That was a long time ago. And then, you know, you had controversies around you, and then people, you were proven innocent, you know, all these things. You have moved on so far, and now you're already reaching the big 30. You're already 30. Okay?
I am 30.
And you don't look
goodness.
It. You don't
really?
Look
thank
it.
You.
So, you know, how does it feel? In Malaysia, at least, I know the media, whenever we write about you, you have left your mark for, first they say, oh, she's a party girl, she's controversial. But actually, Fazura is just doing her own thing. And now at this age, she's done so much, you know, and like I said, at this movie, still the poster, the superstar, you don't see anyone picture being highlighted but Fazura. So how have you gone through all this despite what people were saying, you know, despite accusations, yeah?
My life is quite a journey. It's a learning experience, I think. Yeah. Every chapter of my life was meant to be that way. And I think that whatever I went through last time, whether it's controversial, whether you know people say this and that, it was meant to be there for me to learn. If I didn't go through any of that, then I wouldn't be who I am today. I wouldn't be where I am today. I had to go through those experiences in order for me to be the person I am today. And I'm so blessed. At 30, I feel so relaxed. You know, I mean, when you were young, when you were a lot younger, you're the restless, you know, yes, the restless starlet and whatever. You're confused and you're constantly trying to find who you are and where you are in the industry. But now I think I've sort of walked on a right path, and it led me to where I am today, and I'm so humbled for all my experiences and my learning
journey. So Fazura has no regrets?
I have absolutely no regrets, but there were times that sometimes you look back in life and you say, oh, I could have, should have, would have, but then I think at the end of the day, it was all meant to be there for you. Okay. For me to learn, yeah.
Okay, that's nice to know, like I said, because you got a lot of fans. One thing I noticed, Fazura's fans always stand by her despite whatever people say, you know, there were negative things being said about you, but they're always behind you, they're always supporting. And
I think for me, you need haters in your life. If you don't have haters in your life, yeah, because
why do you need haters in life?
Well, I need haters in my life because I think that they keep me sane. You know, like a lot of people think that, oh, we don't want haters and haters keeps you insane. No, actually, haters keeps you sane. Because if you have everybody who loves you all the time,
then
it gets to your head. And so I think having haters, they keep me grounded and they keep me feeling so loved. And like, you know how haters are so, like, they're constantly investigating you.
Yes.
They're constantly stalking you. To know those people are there means I'm so loved.
Ah, very nicely put, actually. It's a very good advice and tip for all the new stars.
So be grateful for all your haters because they keep you sane, seriously.
Okay, because I guess from haters, you will learn, you know, how to, I guess, prove them wrong, right? Sometimes haters tell you, you can't do this, you can't do that, blah, 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 blah.
And not just that, they will always try to patronize you and, you know, they blemish you and stuff like that with all kinds of stories. But at the end of the day, you need them, I think. You need them to keep talking about you, to say things about you, because the more they say, the more they've been proving wrong, yeah.
Alright. Okay, so because we don't have much time, but before I finish today's Red Carpet with, perhaps your last words for your fans, and of course about your movie, before we wrap up the show.
Okay, so many of my fans out there have missed me, and I've missed you guys too. So I hope that February 6th, Ramai-ramai will come.
Yes, that's
all
when
of you will
come,
yeah,
out, right?
And watch Kami Hysteria. And I know that we have noticed in the last year, the film industry has not been very well. You know, we've not been collecting much money or collection from any of the movies. And so I hope this is a good start for a good year. Kami Hysteria will be a new breath of fresh air and will be a lucky charm for the film industry, where fans will one more time have faith in us in the local film industry, yes.
Okay, thank you so much, Faz, for being with us today, okay? All right, so that's about all the time we have on Red Carpet with Fazura. Wonderful, okay? Excellent journey. We can go on forever, actually, but that's all the time we have. So this is Shah and Faz saying goodbye, and we'll see you guys soon. Thank you.
Bye. Have a good new year.